Well, on the back of very heartfelt pleas from a number of families who earlier this year were bereaved in West Belfast, having lost a son or a daughter to the scourge of drugs misuse, we undertook to try and do something to respond to families' requests for help. And deliberating with the various community organisations, the families themselves, all the relevant statutory bodies from the Health Department, Justice Department, the PSNI and others, we felt there was a need to actually really investigate what really is the nature and the total scale of the problem this community is facing. We brought together a panel of seven people representing the community and the statutory organisations. That's very important for us because the community now is in the lead of examining what the problems are in relation to drugs that this community is facing. We want to try to prevent the loss of life. We want to try and prevent the number of people who are putting their lives at risk by engaging in drugs misuse and abuse. So I'm very, very pleased that we have a seven-member panel which was formally launched publicly this morning with a very good attendance. The audience was filled with people from the education sector, the sporting fraternity, the community sector, the police, the health and the Department of Justice. So it allows us to examine what exactly the community is facing into and more importantly then works out the strategies to tackle the scourge of drugs abuse to save lives in our community.
Well, I'm going to be the independent chair for the panel of seven members. We're going to examine what the extent of the problem of drugs in West Belfast. We're going to look and meet with as many people as possible, including the families and community representatives. But I think we can maybe make recommendations about how we can help from a community perspective, the agencies themselves, to deal better with some of these issues. We hope that some of the resource issues may be identified as well as some of the gaps in services.
Well, I'm here by invitation to support the initiative in West Belfast because I think that it has very, very real potential to contribute to driving the death rate from drug misuse downwards. I'm here as an independent coroner for Northern Ireland, but I have seen the death rate rise over the last number of years. I've held inquests into deaths and tried to highlight the issue, and it seems to me that this is a very good initiative that's worth supporting.
I just want to say I'm honoured to be here. I would also say always remember that the families are the ones who are impacted an awful lot, and it's very, very important that they have a voice. And what I mean by families, I mean family members who have somebody they love with a drug misuse problem, or family members who have somebody they love with an alcohol misuse problem. And it's time that they had a voice and they got heard. So well done, everyone.
Well, as the MP for West Belfast, I'm absolutely delighted that this initiative has been launched here today. I think it shows great leadership from West Belfast to take this very serious issue on board, and obviously with this panel being set up today, seven members are going to be going out into the community over the next number of months, listen to families, listen to other organisations, including anyone who has been negatively impacted upon with regards to the drug search, legal drugs, illegal drugs as well. I have no doubt that the recommendations that will come from this panel in the near future will obviously lead to a better future for many people if those recommendations are implemented. We have to take those recommendations to government. We have to ensure that we're speaking as one voice in this issue because it's a very serious issue that needs to be tackled very, very soon.
Sinn Féin, Gaoananas, Cárta agus Iontas na hÉireann, Equality Rights and Irish Unity.